In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create some crazy stuff with the Turbulent Noise Effect. Hey guys, my name is Manuel. Let's quickly get through some basics first. We add the effect, which you can find under Noise and Grain, to a solid. The Turbulent Noise Effect creates grayscale noise, which you can use to create textures, displacement maps, or backgrounds, for example. You can choose between different fractal types and noise types to begin with. Invert changes black areas to white and white areas to black. More contrast creates more sharply defined black and white areas, less more gray areas. Brightness brightens or darkens the noise overall. In transform you can rotate, scale the width and height at once or individually, or position the noise layers. More complexity adds more depth and detail. Turbulent noise is generated by combining layers of noise. The subsettings basically control how they are combined. By animating the evolution, you basically determine how much the noise evolves over time. Instead of using keyframes, you could also use a time expression. We add an expression and add time asterisk 100, for example, which means the evolution changes at 100 degrees per second. And random seed sets a start value from which to generate the noise. If you want to create a seamless loop, use fractal noise instead of turbulent noise. It has the exact same properties except this setting here, cycle evolution. Activate it, set an evolution keyframe at the beginning, then at the end, plus one frame further, set the number of full revolutions with no degrees, like 3. And you have a seamless loop. Besides that, fractal noise takes longer to render and is the older version of turbulent noise. Alright, let's play with it and create a looping texture, like random vertical lines. Let's keep basic and soft linear. In transform, we deselect uniform scaling and set scale width to a high number like 3000. Scale height and contrast to 5. Then we increase the contrast to 5000, which eliminates most of the gray. And let's increase the brightness, which basically decreases the number of black lines. Let's add posterize time and reduce the frame rate to 4. Awesome. You can use that texture directly on shapes. Let's go into the solid settings and change the color to pink maybe. We need to set the blending mode of the turbulent noise effect to multiply so that the color shines through. Let's undo the color change and use the grayscale noise layer as alpha or luma track mat to cut out pieces out of text, for example. Let's quickly add some. And here in the track mat column, if you can't see it, click down here. We link the text layer to the solid. Let's make the background transparent quickly and click on this left box here to turn it into a luma mask. All right, you can create very unique styles like that. For example, blur parts of your text. We add a solid, add turbulent noise. Keep it pretty basic, increase the contrast 350, scale it up a bit to around 250. We reduce the complexity to 1. Then we link the text layer to the noise layer. Use the noise as luma track mat, which makes it very transparent and large parts disappear. We duplicate the text layer, invert one of the masks so the text is complete again. Then we add Gaussian blur to the upper text layer. Set blurriness to 100, roughly. Deselect repeat edge pixels and parts of our text are blurry. Let's add roughened edges to add some noise to the blurred parts. We set scale to 10 and complexity to 10 as well. You then could animate the evolution of the turbulent noise effect. Let's use a time expression again. Time asterisk 100. Awesome. And like that you can create truly unique animated text from scratch. Before we move on, let's check out an amazing animation course by Domestika. Learn how to create expressive typography in motion with After Effects. Design letter forms in Illustrator and animate them in After Effects. Start with research and references, color, then design a lettered phrase in Illustrator. In After Effects, animate it using kinetic typography. I've added the link to this course and all animation courses to the description. And even better, use the code MANUEL10 for an extra 10% off. Let's combine turbulent noise with some other effects, like displacement map. We add the effect to a footage file. Displacement map needs a displacement map layer, so let's create that. We add a solid, add turbulent noise. Let's use block as noise type this time. Contrast around 200. In transform, we deselect uniform scaling, scale width 6000, scale height 10. We hide the noise layer, and in displacement map, we use the solid as a displacement map layer. Effects and masks, we increase max horizontal displacement. And that's how you create glitch effects. Animate this property, and in turbulent noise, the contrast and the scale properties. Check out the free project file to see how I animated the scene. Then there is time displacement. We add a simple shape using the rectangle tool and animate the position. We move it to the right with two position keyframes. We quickly smooth the animation using the graph editor. Slow down the end and the beginning, of course. We add time displacement to the shape layer. Again, we need a time displacement layer. We add a solid, add turbulent noise. Contrast 500, brightness minus 40, and complexity 1. Then we add mosaic. Horizontal blocks 1. Vertical blocks 30. And we use sharp colors. We choose the solid as time displacement map layer, effects and masks. Set the max displacement time to 2 seconds. It would be great to see something, so let's move the map layer below. White means the animation starts immediately. The darker it is, the more delay it has. And black is the max time displacement, 2 seconds. An easy way to add some crazy details to boring shape animations. Finally, let's use the turbulent noise effect to automatically scale objects, depending on the luminosity, using an expression. I've already added a solid with an animated turbulent noise effect. Then we add a shape. I use the ellipse tool to add a disk. I quickly resize it to 100 pixels each. We want to animate the scale, let's add an expression to the scale property. First, we establish a variable, x equals. Then we link it to the solid, which is the layer we pick our information from. Dot sampleImage, which reads the color data of the noise layer. In parentheses, transform.position. Which means at the actual position of the shape, comma, in square brackets 1,1 defines the sample area, 1 pixel in each direction, comma, true, after effects and masks are applied. Important because we use a turbulent noise effect, comma, time, which means the current comp time. And finally in square brackets, 0. We only address the x value, semicolon at the end. Then we add the actual expression. X equals, in square brackets, x comma x. We need to multiply that by 100, which results in a scale value between 0 and 100, depending on the actual luminosity of the turbulent noise effect at that position. Now, you have to duplicate and position the disks. Make sure to check out the free project file and all the other links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.